Hey Charles.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, have you heard about data queries in SimCenter Test Lab Neo?
I have, and I want to hear more about it because I'm not sure how to use it.
Oh, yeah, it's quite something. But the easiest way to use it, you go to this display tab here, and normally this is set to regular data.
Yep.
But to use the queries, here's the big trick. You got to say data as queries. What do you think of that, Charles?
That seems simple enough. I can do
Yeah,
that.
and then if, like I got three runs of data here, and if I grab this auto power from one of the runs, the preview display shows it right away, which is good. But to use the queries, you got to actually use a fixed display, like a front back. So I just hit this plus here, opened a new front back, and now I'm going to drag this data in. And do you see this little queue here?
Yeah.
That means this data is ready to be used as a query, Charles.
That makes sense.
Okay, so we had data as queries. If I didn't have that on, there would be no queue, but now there is. And I dragged and dropped it into a fixed display. And now I'm going to hit the icon next to it called Display Queries.
Okay.
And this shows all the queries that are available now. So I got one queue showing. So I got one queue here. And it shows, this is the section name of the data, 80 kilometers per hour. This is the run, the type of measurement, etc. And I got
Okay.
this little pull down here or drop down. And you see, I'm showing one channel of data here. But if I go in and I
Yeah.
turn on these other runs, hit OK, it updates the displays and shows them all. I can go here to
Wow.
options, and I can say, show me the run name just to prove it to you. Yeah, wow, indeed. Yeah,
That is nice.
it is pretty nice, isn't it? I could kind of
Yeah.
do the same thing with maybe a different display here. Let's try and do something a little more elaborate, shall we? Like a 1x2 display.
Let's get
Yeah,
fancy.
and I'll put this mount there, and I'll just look at it in log because I like log. I'll also turn on the run name. Do it in advance this time. And I could maybe go to the octaves here, grab some octave data, and also turn on the run name. And do you like your octaves looking like that, or would you prefer them to look more like that?
Locks is, yeah, there we
Yeah,
go. That's my preferred.
preferred way, maybe even octave format here. So now I got two displays, each with a queue. So if I go up to Display Queries, notice it shows me three queues total. That's because back
Yeah.
here in this front back, I had a query, and then it highlighted for
Okay.
me because in the active display here, I have two queries, and I can come in and I can say, hey, now I want to see the same runs, and let's see what happens here. And instead of hitting OK, I'll just hit Update Displays. And notice it found in the three runs. So I'm expecting both displays to update with the three runs here. So as I pick things up here, Charles, it shows the resulting queries, the individual queries down below here. And I got three runs of data in the top one, three in the bottom one.
Oh, that's going to save me a lot of time with reporting.
Yeah, it's pretty quick. I think one of the dangers of using a query, you can kind of do things you maybe didn't mean to do. So, for example, I could grab this data from, again, switch it here, and I'll say the run name here. I got run one, and then I could
Yeah, that's.
go to run two and grab the data, and then I could
Okay.
go to run three and grab the data. Notice I got three queues here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit different than over here. I had three data, but I had a single line here indicating all this, the three data curves resulted from a single query. But now I got three queries. And so if I go up to,
Those. So that's three individual queries.
That's right. Three individual highlighted them for me. I could highlight the other ones, but I'll go back to what it highlighted by default. And now notice I can't really do the run name because these are three separate queries. If I picked like one of these and added all three runs and hit update displays. See, that's kind of a little funky. I modified one of the three queries because I treated them all as individual queries instead of a single query and then adding more data.
Okay. I can see the difference there.
Yeah. Let me show you one other thing to maybe be aware of. Maybe I'll, since the menu is getting a little bit busy, I'll delete a few of these here. And I'll just start from scratch with a single display. And let's go back to run one. So I got an auto power. Instead of the front, though, I'm going to put it in the back. Okay.
Okay.
And again, I can say format log, can turn on the run name. And then I could come here and say, I want to see this acoustic data, and I'll also put it in the back.
Okay.
Notice what it did by putting it in the back, Charles. I got...
So I can... Different units, I can graph at the same time then.
Yeah. But if I'm putting them in the front can have only one set, a common set of units. So if you were, you know, if, let's say I just even try this again. Front doesn't like it, right?
Okay.
But if I take back, it's all good. Okay. And then I can do the display queries and again show, you know, for both the acoustic and the vibration data all overlaid, show it all, you know, for all three runs. Pretty cool.
That's a good tip. No, it's a great tip. So if I'm making a query, so I have the option of having different engineering units.
Yeah. And you can, they overlay automatically, even though they're different units.
Nice. Thanks for the tip.
Yeah. Hey, enjoy your data queries there, Charles.
I will. Thank you.